Every day around the world, EOD and Counter-IED teams put their lives on the line to protect critical infrastructures, forces and populations. These teams are at the forefront of the fight against terrorism and face tremendous challenges from physical exhaustion to mental strain caused by high precision work and a dangerous environment. NATO has a responsibility to support these men and women so they can accomplish their tasks safely and more easily. For this reason, the Alliance is partnering with industry to provide EOD and Counter-IED teams with new and innovative technology, such as the exoskeleton.
The development of an exoskeleton to assist with improvised explosive device disposal is a very good idea. Having worn the suit over 22 years in the army and since, I found that the weight can damage your body in the long term, and anything to reduce the burden of the weight of the suit is excellent. I used to be 5'8". I lost 2 inches because my spine is all crushed. I also have shattered knees, my hips are playing up, and a development like this 20, 30 years ago would have helped me a lot.
We have to carry that bomb suit, which is 45 kilos. We have to take out the robot from the vehicle. This is also about 50 kilos. We have to deal with that weight of that special equipment and also with the heat.
In Afghanistan and Iraq, 1/3 of the evacuations were muscular skeletal related injuries. This system, what it does is it takes the weight off the soldier and brings it to the ground completely, so it's load bearing. So it's to prevent injuries and to help you carry the weight.
These trials main aim was to investigate and prove that the exoskeleton technology can support the EOD operations.
The agency has a commitment to make sure that NATO forces will remain future-proof. We want to make sure that this exoskeleton technology is also exposed to the military community, so the military community start preparing for receiving such technology into the battle space in the next years.
Well, for us, this workshop was a very good opportunity because we can learn. And we see and understand much better what are the requirements of the military end users. And at the same time, the exoskeleton companies see what is related to EOD and how they might have to adjust their exoskeleton.
What we found from this preliminary data is that using the exoskeleton apparatus, the human performance can be done with a less effort than not using the exoskeleton.
Exoskeleton is the new frontier.
I think the outcome of this can be just positive for the users, and from the trials we did already, I'm very optimistic that we can go big steps ahead in the relatively near future, actually.